Hi, I'm Patricia Bleckman with KE2 Therm. This video takes a look at what makes the KE2 Controlled Environment unique from other KE2 Therm controllers and as well as seemingly similar competitive products for controlling your walk-in freezers, walk-in coolers, or other commercial refrigeration systems. The firmware for the KE2 Controlled Environment builds off the KE2 Evaporator Efficiency's energy-saving defrost, and it includes the same fan management features, Ethernet communications, alarm notifications via text or email, graphing, and data logging. Then we program the KE2 Controlled Environment with additional intelligence for humidity control. This is essential in the refrigeration of perishable products with a high sensitivity to humidity, like berries, medicine, wine, clean rooms, curing rooms, and so on. The KE2 Controlled Environment kit includes a humidity sensor, which measures the relative humidity in the refrigerated environment. The controller will manage humidity in two stages. First, the controller uses the refrigeration system's inherent dehumidification property and maximizes it by increasing and decreasing the coil temperature to remove more or less water depending on whether the humidity needs to be increased or decreased. And you can also add it for an external digital switch for a humidifier, dehumidifier, or external electric heat. Like the KE2 Evap, the KE2 Controlled Environment provides the same powerful capability to be viewed on-site or remotely if connected to the KE2 Smart Access Portal. And you can receive alarm alerts via text or email to stay connected 24/7. When accessing the controller, you will see the web pages of the KE2 Evap and KE2 Controlled Environment are basically the same. But there are some differences to note. On the home page, in addition to the standard home page values for the temperature and pressure inputs and relay and digital input status, users are provided with a humidity value. On the set points page, you will see three additional set points that are specific to this controller. First, the minimum and maximum superheat settings, humidity offset and humidity delay, and humidity control target and optional heater control selection for an external device. Then on the graphs page, notice that the controller graphs room temperature and room humidity values, not coil temperature like the KE2 Evap. That's a brief summary of the KE2 Controlled Environment and its unique humidity control features. If you're interested in learning more about the KE2 Evap or KE2 Smart Access that I also mentioned in this video, we do have several YouTube videos covering the programming, installing, and troubleshooting those products and others. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to be notified of newly posted tech support videos. For additional information on the KE2 Controlled Environment, please visit our website or contact our tech support line.